Welcome to the ThinkCell Tutorials. The library gives you access to slide templates, icons, stock images, and your own slide and image assets, all directly within PowerPoint. The library makes it easy to find the perfect visual to engage your audience with access to FreePic, Pexels, and Unsplash. You have literally millions of icons and stock images to choose from. These sources are free to use with your ThinkCell installation. If you have a subscription to Brandfolder, Canto, or Getty Images, you can use these providers in the library as well. This tutorial shows you how to insert images and icons from online providers as ThinkCell elements in your presentation, and how to position, resize, and crop them. To insert an image from an online provider in your presentation, open the library. In the PowerPoint ribbon, go to the Insert tab and select Library. Next, select one of the online providers, like Pexels. Then enter a search term, let's say groceries. When browsing thumbnails, you can zoom in and out by holding Control and rotating the mouse wheel. With a touchpad, pinch and stretch. Select the image you want to insert by clicking the thumbnail. If you don't want to insert it on your current slide, just select the slide where you want the image to appear. Right now, Lock Positions by default is on, so you can either insert an image anywhere on the slide, or you can snap the orange frame to a suggested alignment. Let's snap the orange frame to the right edge of the slide. Click once to insert the image. As you can see, when you add a new element, ThinkCell automatically adjusts the position and size of all ThinkCell elements for an optimal slide layout. For more information on automatic layout and locking positions by default, see our user manual section on layout. If you want to replace an image on a slide in the same position, double-click the current image to open the library, then select a new thumbnail. To manually position an image, use the white handles to adjust the edges of the image. ThinkCell resizes the image accordingly. You can also drag the image to a new position. Images that you manually position have closed locks and red grid lines. As you add more elements to a slide, a locked image stays where it is. Let's snap the image back to the right side of the slide. Let's say we want to crop the image to focus on the bag of cookies. To do so, we'll use the black crop handles. If you see a double-ended white arrow cursor, move your mouse just inside the selection frame so that you see a black cropping cursor. Drag the crop handle to adjust the crop region. If you then use the white handles to change the shape of the image, you can see that the crop region remains in focus. To restore the original image, open the lock, then on the Picture Format tab, select Reset Picture and Size. Next, let's add an icon. Open the library, select FreePic, and enter a search term. For example, let's search for trophy. When you're searching for icons, FreePic has additional options for filtering and sorting the results. In color, you can filter for black icons, color icons, or icons with a color gradient. To show all icons, select all. In style, you can filter for icons with just an outline, icons with a color fill, lineal color icons with an outline and a fill, or icons with a hand-drawn style. To show all icons, select all. You can also sort the results by how relevant they are to your search term, or how recently they were added to FreePic. We want a black icon with just an outline. We'll sort the results by most relevant. To insert the icon, click the thumbnail once, then choose where to place it on your slide. To make sure it's aligned with the text box and the other icons, snap the orange frame to the grid lines. Click once to add it to the slide. Like images, icons also have a blue selection frame and a black cropping frame. With an icon, you use the blue frame to control the icon's alignment relative to other elements. Unlike images, when you change the blue frame, the icon stays the same size. To resize the icon with the mouse, use the blue resize arrow. To expand the icon, click and drag the arrow to the bottom right. To resize an icon with more precision, use the mini toolbar. Let's say you want to make sure the trophy icon is exactly the same size as the other icons. If you select the other icons, you see in the mini toolbar that their height is 40 points. So let's make the trophy icon 40 points as well. In the size menu, you can select a size or type a custom size, in this case 40 points. You can also set the icon height in millimeters, centimeters, inches, or as a proportion of the slide width or height. In the mini toolbar, you can also choose the horizontal alignment or vertical alignment of icons. ThinkCell inserts elements from FreePic as icons, and elements from Pexels, Unsplash, and other providers as images. However, you can change this behavior at any time. For example, in the mini toolbar, you can make an element from FreePic behave like an image by selecting Image. Or, you can make an element from Pexels behave like an icon by selecting Icon. By default, your list of library sources contains the image and icon providers that are free to use with ThinkCell: FreePic, Pexels, and Unsplash. If you have a subscription to Brandfolder, Canto.com, or Getty Images Premium Access, you can add these providers to the library as well. If you don't see some of these providers, you might be able to add them in the library's configuration mode. For more information, see the user manual section on adding image and icon providers to the library. And that's it for this tutorial on online image and icon providers. You can also add images from your own computer or network to the library and find them again in seconds when you want to insert them in a presentation. To learn more about this and other kinds of library content, see our other tutorials.